Alright guys, welcome back to another video about my PC build. So I have made a couple upgrades since the last build log video, and here we are. I've actually upgraded my case. You'll notice that instead of my 800D from Corsair, I have upgraded or downgraded to an NZXT S340. So this is a much smaller, more compact case. It's a mid tower instead of a full tower, and it's about 60% the size of the 800D. And I wanted to downgrade because the 800D was a bit too big for me. There was a lot of empty space unused inside of the case, and it was really difficult to move around. So this one is quite a bit smaller, more compact, and it looks pretty nice because this is the white S340, matches my color scheme. So I have done a couple modifications to the case. You'll notice over here on the top, this is not what it naturally looks like. I have actually put some white carbon fiber vinyl on top. So this is from, this is a vinyl made for cars, and basically it's like a big sticker. And I just used that to cover up the top of the case, which is originally black, and that doesn't really match the rest of the case, which is all white. So that's why I covered that part, and I think it looks a lot better now. I would have liked to bring this all the way up to the front, but there's IO over here, and I would actually need to cut holes in the white carbon fiber if I wanted to be able to access that. So I didn't want to try cutting holes in it yet because I'm not very experienced with cutting vinyls. But I might do that in the future, that's an option. Inside the case, you'll see I've upgraded a couple parts as well. So first of all, the fans. I actually have bought new fans. One in the back, two are in the front. These are noise blocker E-loops, 120mm B12PS fans. So they are very nice, high static pressure white fans, and these are the PWM silent version, so I can control them with my motherboard very accurately, and they are also very quiet, so that's a good plus. Here you can see my modded H100i, which I painted and made a video about before. But one recent change was the RAM over there. You'll actually see that used to be black, and I painted it white. It looks quite a bit better now, I think. So there's the white sleeve cables still for the CPU up in the corner there, motherboard 24 pin, and the graphics card cables. Down here, you'll see there is my SSD, and I actually wrapped that in the white carbon fiber vinyl as well, which I think looks pretty nice. And down over there, where my sound card is, there's a white-sleeved front panel audio cable going into it. And basically, the radiators over here with the two fans got lighting all along the top and the side. And the lighting I actually made a custom switch for, so it's just at the back over here. You can easily turn it on and off at the press of the switch, and that way I can turn it off when I leave my computer on, since it's on 24/7. That way these bright lights aren't on all night, so it's very nice and pretty useful too. The lighting are two 30cm Bit Phoenix Alchemy white LED strips. I know it looks kind of blue in the video, but that's because of the camera white balance. So yeah, it actually looks white in real life. But they are pretty bright LED strips. So what I did is I connected them to a 3-pin fan header at the bottom of the motherboard, and I can actually use my software on my computer, AI Suite, to control the brightness of the lighting depending on the temperature. But I basically have it just set so I can change it from the computer, and that way I can have it lower than 100%, because 100% is pretty bright. So I think I can show you guys over here. Let's see, this will focus, and maybe not, but you guys can see over here I can change this, and I can set it to, see if I can set it to disable. And then over here, I can just press apply, and there we go. Now it's at full brightness, and you can see it's a lot brighter now. Very, very bright. But I set it to 70% so that it's not so bright, and it still looks pretty nice. So let me just put it back to 70%. And there we go. So very simple and easy to do with the software with my motherboard. I basically painted my RAM, I wrapped my SSD in white carbon fiber, and also the PCIe expansion slot covers at the back over there. You can see they are white. Those were originally black, but I found they didn't really match the color scheme since the whole back of the case is white and those were black. So I decided to paint those, and they're also white. And yeah, so that's just about all of the changes. I'll quickly take off the front panel and side panel here to show you in just a second. All right,
there you go. Here are the two fans at the front. The two noise blocker E-loop fans, very quiet. And they're basically pushing air through my radiator and out the back over there. Over here on the front panel, I actually have the interior lined with Silverstone sound dampening acoustic foam. So this is to absorb some of the sound coming from the fans and all the other components inside the case. So basically makes everything a bit quieter. It's not fully quiet, of course, but I have this on the front panel and also around the back of the case. On the inside, I filled it with sound dampening foam. And the compartment underneath there where the PSU is, that's also all lined in acoustic foam. So it basically reduces the loud, any loud whining noises from fans or any components to a low rumble, and it sounds a lot better. So I'll just take off the side panel here. Alright, so this is what the system looks like without the side panel. There's the white NZXT bar over here with the NZXT logo. I'm actually planning on replacing this water cooling H100i with something better next year, this coming year, which is going to be pretty soon. And I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to do, but I want something a bit better than this that performs a lot better and will look a bit better too. So that's some of my plans. And I think just about everything else here is looking good. You can see the LEDs here at the top, at the front. Here's some more sound dampening foam. You can see the whole roof of the case is lined in it. And over here is the little switch that turns on and off the lights. So that's about it for this build update here. I have a lot of cool pictures to show you that will look a lot better than this does in the video. So just stay tuned to the end, and you'll be able to see a lot better pictures of what the system looks like. So that's it for me. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you guys in the next vlog.